Okay, so this is a photography training. It's a real-time training, and this is like the basic level, and I charge
800.
8,800 rupees for it. 8,000. Okay, so you can contact me in this number. This is basically my photography number. Okay, the one which you have is my training number. Okay, so I have two numbers, so one for photography and another for training. So we start around 8:30 to 8:45 because normally people don't wake up on this time. 7:15 is very good for ideal for photography because it's quite a morning where you have the light, yellowish light from the sun, and it will be cold as well. But nowadays I'm starting it from 8:45 because people are not present at this point of time. So we start with icebreaker, which is nothing but getting to know about you and me, and we understand about why do you enjoy photography, and then we talk about the equipments which we have, like what are the required equipments which you have to bring, and then we understand what we're gonna learn today. Okay, so this will take about 15-20 minutes, and then we gonna go for another half an hour session where we talk about the camera concepts, like what actually inside the DSLR and how different the DSLR from the other cameras, like if you have like your mobile cameras and your digital cameras which you buy for cheaper price, and what is inside the camera, and we understand what actually goes on after the shoot, like what are the other things which you have to do after the shoot, like you take pictures of an event or something like that, and then what we have to do after that, and then we understand about the camera overview. We completely understand over the structure of the camera, what where and all is there, what is lens and how to mount the lens, how to release the lens, and what are the keys and functions in the camera. I am particularly sure about Nikon, but Canon, yes, I will be telling you how to do that as well. We talk about all these functionalities of the camera, which I've mentioned it here, which will take a half an hour for me to introduce to all these functionalities, and just to give you a demo on things, like what actually it is. And then we don't talk in depth about these things, we just talk overview of these things. That's
This is
what we
any
are doing.
classroom training or this camera
No, this
course?
will be like on the Lal Bagh. Basically, that's where I train people. Lal Bagh is a botanical garden, so we have a good amount of space where we can sit and talk about it. Okay. And we talk about the composition of photography,
And
like.
your screen just gone.
Can't see it.
No, I say white screen.
Okay, let me just share it again. Can you see it now?
Now yes, yeah.
Okay, that sounds good. Anyway, so we talk about the genres of photography, like event photography. We talk about the fashion photography, and then wildlife photography, and what kind of what do you actually want to capture? I mean, it depends on the taste of the people. Some people like capturing it, while it moves. Some blurry image should be there, something like that. So it depends on the people's composition, how they like it to take the photos of. And then we talk about the default modes in the camera, which is like programmable, apertures priority, and shutter priority, and manual. So we talk about these four concepts in the default mode. I mean, default mode is something like it's already pre-configured, which comes with every camera. And these are like customized ones, which we have to specify a specific aperture only setting, and the shutter speed only. And this is like programmable specific, and this is like manual setting where you can override all these settings. Okay. And we talk about ISO. What is the concept of ISO? What is shutter? What is aperture? And what is white balance? So these are the four important concepts in any photos you're gonna take. White balance is automatic. It is best when you keep it in automatic, and you can also adjust it based on the background light and the foreground light. And we talk about histograms in the sense like after taking every picture, you just it gives you a quick glance of checking out how the image is going to look like. Even not even looking at the image, you can see the histogram of the image and understand that this is going to be a very good image or it's going to be a crappy image. So I'll be teaching you how to do that, and then. We're going to talk about camera composition. So we are going to understand what are the lines, angles and frames in the camera, and we can understand what is the color, how to adjust the color accordingly, and how to adjust the contrast. And then we can understand how to focus on a foreground or a background subject, how to use manual focus, how to use automated focus, what is a focus ring, and how to do those things again. And then we're going to understand what is the zoom focal point will again cover in the focus again, and manual focus. So both are being covered in the focus again. So zoom also will be covered, like there are two types of lens. One is like a zoom lens and other one is like a prime lens, we call it. Prime lens are basically pretty much unzoomable, and zoom lens are like it's zoomable to an extent where the lens can contrast. How further the lens can contrast, that much it can zoom and capture the remote area of the picture. There are two types of aperture, it depends on the zoom. So there are again two types of zoomable lens, one which will have a variable aperture and another one will have a constant aperture no matter how far you zoom it. So those things we will be discussing about that in the composition. And then we understand about the in-depth of lens and camera. So we understand the types of lenses available, and we can understand the stability issues when you are using a lens, and how you can stabilize your picture. And then we can understand in-lens functionalities, like how your lens would function, and which sort of lens you need to take for which sort of events. So that we will discuss, and hood, scamp, and build of the lens. So I will be recommending you certain types of lens for different things, and I will be telling you about the accessories which comes with the lens and how you have to protect the lens to the max. Okay, and then we talk about depth of field, where we have we will capture amazing bokeh. So bokeh is like, you know, blurring the background to an extent where it melts down. Okay, so we're gonna capture that. And then we're gonna see the type of memory cards we have to equip ourselves with, and where to buy lens and how to buy lens. And that's the end of the topic. So in where to buy and what to buy, I'll be telling about the second-hand lenses and how you have to examine the second-hand lenses before buying the lens. So that's also we covered in this training program.
So this is 800 rupees, right?
Yes.
And what would be, while coming out of this, after completing this course, what would be learned? I mean,
you'll be learning this complete understanding about the modes in your camera. You will know which mode to select at which point of time. Will know how to adjust the white balance. You will know how to adjust the aperture, how to adjust the shutter speed, and how to adjust the ISO.
Are we having any photo shoot after explaining all this? Are you making us to shoot some photos and
Of course, every topic after gets over, we're gonna do real time in the sense like I'll be populating images in my camera, and I want you to populate the same kind of image or even better image in your camera. So it's gonna be real time. So we are going to shoot. It is nothing theory here. If I'm talking about the aperture, right? So for example, I'm talking about the aperture. So aperture would be, the default aperture would be, it depends on your lens. So for example, my lens has a default aperture of what, 2.8. Okay, so I will be shooting pictures in 2.8 with different ISO settings. Now this training is basically just to see how the aperture works here. Okay,
yeah.
With having a bigger aperture of 2.8, we're gonna see how much light it's gonna let inside the lens, and we're gonna see that what is the difference between changing the aperture and getting it to the right amount. Okay, and then we adjust ISO to settle up the aperture. So we kind of compensate the aperture. We give more ISO. When we compensate the ISO, we'll give more aperture. So we're gonna see like one by one. We're gonna see the shutter speed, aperture, and ISO all side by side. We'll be seeing live examples of compensating each one of these, because anything in camera, you have to compensate at least one of those factors. Okay, without that, you cannot get a good photo. Okay, either you have to compensate the ISO or the shutter or the aperture. So one sacrifice you have to do for sure. So I'll be telling you like what and all you have to do towards this. So this training is completely hands-on, which means like you have to populate all those things which I'm populating. And we will be having a nice time. It will be like I won't be getting like 10-15 people or not in my group, because I see normally photo walks goes for like 10-15 people, but I really don't do that. So I do only with 2-3 people, you know,
yeah.
maximum 4 people, that's it. Because when you give your personal attention to each one of them, and they might get this 3 to 4 hours will be more than enough for them to understand about the photography. And whatever I learned it from my experience, so it will be easy for me to share my experience with others, and it becomes an easy task for them to learn as well.
Yeah, and what you told me, that is important actually. At what point of time, what to use to get that photo?
Yes.
What mode to use, that is very important.
Yes,
yeah.
Because most of the time I go to an event. So, for example, I went to a fashion show, and
yeah.
What happened is like this photograph I was taking, so this one. So
yeah.
there, normally the fashion show happens in a huge light and all those things, but
yeah.
the problem was like there was no light there.
Yeah.
So it was like pretty dark. So I had to populate this picture with that much of light. So immediately I have to take 2 to 3 clicks, understand the picture, and after adjust my ISO, shutter speed and aperture. So
yeah.
so that it can populate this much light. Even though I was using flash, okay, there was a flash being used there. You can identify it easily. There's a flash being used there because there was no other way of populating a light there. So we use flash. And we focus the flash on upward. So I have a specific flash-oriented training, which comes in advance. So how to use flash in terms of populating the images with good amount of light, and you can focus the flash in different ways and methods. So I'll be like teaching you that.
Again, they will do this right, and especially during marriages, they will take some pics in such a way that they will highlight bride and bridegroom, and they will just blur the background.
Yeah, that is a bokeh actually.
That also covers, right?
Yes, this is amazing bokeh. So this is covered in that. So it's like if you see this picture, you can see this flower is highlighted, the rest of the background is blurred out, right? So
yes.
this is bokeh actually, whatever is comes out behind it. So it is out of focus. So you can see that these people also are getting out of focus. And also here, you can see an amazing smooth of image backside,
yeah.
right?
Yeah.
So it's because of that effect. Okay, so you focus majorly on the subject, and you put it on a very low aperture.
Yeah.
And what
we should
happens
understand
is like
if you want to blur our background, what we should do. If you want everything, what we should do.
So you can see this image. Now, if
yeah.
you see this image, everything is crystal clear, right? Even the end of the ocean will be crystal clear. Why? Because we're not using the bokeh. In this image, if you see, bokeh will be used on the front foreground of the image. But background will not be blurred, okay? Because we are mainly focusing on the background, and foreground is irrelevant to us,
yes.
right? So there are situations. Now, if you say the food photography, now you can see that the food has to be highlighted, and I want the juice of the food. If you see the original photo over here, you can really see the juice on the
yeah.
the food, okay?
Just mind interaction, what we are expecting and what we should do to get that image like that.
Yeah, I'll just show you. In my photography page.
And you are the one over here, sitting on with the...
Come again?
Yeah, this is you.
Yeah, it's me. So here, if I go to photos, okay, so in here, this was the photo I was explaining you. So, okay, now if you see here, everything is clustered here. It's because I have a very less amount of, probably a wide amount of aperture here to capture much information here towards this picture. So I don't let blur anywhere, okay? But in terms of pictures like a flower and all those things, I want to blur the background. I'm not sure about this
we
one.
We should know what kind of... Actually, we should know what we are thinking, what we are trying to capture, and what mode we should set.
Yes, exactly. These are my studio shoots, okay? So this is nothing. I mean, studio shoots are very simple and straightforward. It's all simulated lightnings. lighting will be simulated and it will be on the position where you want to keep it.
Yeah.
If you see this picture, this is a different training again. This is comes in advanced training where I teach about the studio lighting, how to set it up. Now you can see that the light falls over here, which is like little soft. And the background light, you see that one? That is from a different light. This gives you a background texture over this picture on his face, to just to highlight his background, saying that he has a little rough background because of his beard here.
Yeah.
All right, and this is like soft. So this kind of you can do a lot of things on the studios, but that is simulated. Okay, we have our own studio.
Okay, this and come down with the couples. That is. Taking different kind of photo shoot or
yes, this is completely different. I mean, the idea behind the shoot is like the couple should be highlighted and their eyes should look good. So normally focus on the eyes. Okay, so if you see this picture, the eyes will be like highlighted here. We don't care about the background, but we care about their eyes and their hairstyle.
Yeah.
It should be like smooth as butter.
Yeah.
So the same thing happens here as well. Okay. So these are like very simple photographs which anyone can take it. There is no problem that you or me, anyone can take this. There's no problem. The problem comes when you are going for a party and all of this sudden you don't have light. When you don't have light, then the actual problem happens and you have to simulate a light accordingly and you have to compromise a particular factor. Either you compromise the aperture or you increase the ISO, which creates a very noisy image. But then you have to compromise. Compromise is mandatory no matter what picture you're going to take. So this is a flower picture, so you can see that book here. So this is a book here over here, which is on the top. You see that? So it's all blurred and also it's like very smooth blurred. It's not like, we just use the software and blur it. It happens in the camera, it populates in the camera.
So
the camera,
we need to set in the camera, right? How much to blur?
That is aperture basically. So you have to set up the aperture accordingly so that it blurs a little amount or completely it melts the image.
Yeah.
Alright, so that will be taught to you how to do that and how to get an amazing image out of your camera. And the best picture will always look good on your camera and when you edit it, it becomes much better. So
editing, do we need to learn Photoshop or what again?
Yeah, of course. You have to learn photography. You can see here, this image should be shot by 4.8 or 5 aperture. But in this image, you can see like it is shot by 2 or 2.8. So that should be. So you can see, cannot see anything in the background. Or background is a little far away from this. So either that could be a reason. So you can see the background here.
Again, how much days does it take to learn that Photoshop and normally?
Photoshop, it comes with practice, okay? I recommend people to start editing right away once they start learning the KT from me, the knowledge transfer from me. Once they get the knowledge transfer from me, they can start editing it right away. Photoshop is basically like you have a page, so what you do is like you upload two images. One image is like original image which you got from the camera. Another image is going to be the edited one. So you just go back, come forward, go back, come forward. Okay.
Yeah.
And then you understand which one is better. Okay. And then you work on that particular Photoshopped item and make it better than what it looks here on a real camera. Okay. Now, if you take this image for instance and you want to make this better. Now, what can you do to make this image better? That's the question I ask to the people who comes for the photography training. What can you do?
Instead of editing in the Photoshop, we can took the image better way, right? By using camera only.
Sometimes you cannot able to do that, right? Sometimes you'll be able to do it. Sometimes you might not able to do it, right?
Okay.
This is the situation. I mean, no matter how hard you try, you can hold the camera for 2 to 3 seconds without shaking, right? Yeah, so because when you buy a lot of advanced camera like FX, okay, full frame cameras, and when you buy a very decent lens like a 24-70, right? So what happens is like the camera's weight will be like around 5 to 6 kilos, okay, which you cannot bear it because my camera is like that, okay? You cannot bear the weight of it. The camera becomes pretty heavy. So in that time. When you click a picture, right, you might make some mistakes. So that's where you get into Photoshop or you get into Corel or any other software for that matter. Okay. And when you do that,
Photoshop is the leading, right? For the actually.
Come again.
Photoshop is the leading, right? Editor. Normally for functions and for camera.
Yeah, you can use any editors
for
that
marriages
matter.
they'll
I normally use Lightroom and Photoshop for editing purposes. But anyone can use any software. It doesn't matter actually. Yeah. So it's all about how to make this photo even better. Okay, so if I want to frame this and put it on my wall, I want to make sure that the mountains looks amazing and there is little more clouds over here, and clouds might should be highlighted, and the whites on the water should not be too bright. Okay, and the white on the boat should not over bright. Okay, so when you see a picture, you should be pleasant. So when you go to Photoshop, you can see that how much whites are there here, how much whites are there here, how much whites are there here. You can also see the shadow in the picture. So you need a raw picture for that, but that is mandatory. When you have the raw picture, you can bring out the shadow with you can little brighten the shadow part. So you can see that this part is shadowed. So we can even brighten that part, okay? And when you see too much white in this boat, you can reduce the white in that particular area. So those things can be done using Photoshop, because sun cannot be predicted, okay? Sun sometimes might be harsh on the target, so only Photoshop can edit it when you have a raw picture with it, right? So that's why we need a particular lesson on Photoshop to understand how actually we can reduce or increase the brightness to make the picture look perfect.
Again, that take 2 to 3 days, right, to learn the Photoshop?
I can teach you within a day. You can record that video, and you can just play it again and look at it again. When you practice only, you can become perfect. Until you don't practice, there's no guarantee given to you.
Yeah, that's why if you go to any camera shops and anything, if you give some photo, they will edit it in seconds.
Yes, because of the practice, because they use shortcuts, hotkeys.
Yeah.
They use hotkeys for that. So they just do it in seconds because of the practice they have in their hands.
They remove everything on the face and they will look here.
So you can also isolate the background. For example, I can show you this picture. So here, I had a crappy background. My background was too crappy. So I just edited this picture in such a way that I removed the background. I put a white, it's not even white, it's gray structure on the background. And I made it perfect. Do you see the difference? Before the picture was like here, there was like, I was using a white cloth, which has a lot of wrinkles. Okay, so many wrinkles are there. But after Photoshop, it looks like this. There is no wrinkles. You don't know that it is a white background. Okay,
yeah,
maybe
yeah.
I change the color of it. Okay, so this is the this is what you can do in the post shoot. Right, and you can make it even better. It's not a perfect picture. You can make it even better, but I really don't have the time for it to do that. But yes, you can make it still better. You can make it like say stuff, And this is my my recent clicks on the parties. Okay, it's an event actually. So you can see event photography is completely different. You have to be ready for it. You have to have work on a higher shutter speed. Okay, a shutter has to go really fast because people are moving here. You see that the kids are moving. Okay,
moving,
so in this scenario, we have to use a completely different setting than what we used before. That is a studio photography, and the person is standing and posing. But this is not that; it just changes within seconds. So, this girl was standing like this for 1.5 seconds. So you have to click the picture within 1.5 seconds, and the pose has to come perfectly, or else the client will not be happy about it, right? So you have to be very precise. So you can see that I'm sacrificing the shutter speed here. Okay, when I sacrifice the aperture, you can see that some of the part of the pictures are little blurred in the background. You see, I don't want to do that. I want to take maximum clear picture everywhere, but I cannot do that because there is no light here. If I want to bring on light, I have to increase the ISO. Increasing the ISO, do you see a spot here? You will be, if you closely examine, you will see a lot of spots. It's because of ISO. If you increase the ISO again, you will get a lot of spots over here. So you have to be very very fast in terms of deciding what your ISO would be, what your aperture would be, and what your shutter speed would be. okay? For immediately, this is not a dance move, okay? They're just moving little slowly. So what I do is like I decrease my shutter speed so that I can let in more light by expanding my aperture. So like that, you have to change and you have to keep clicking for those. And that's how you know, you get perfect.
Yeah,
I mean,
it's,
if you ask me how many pictures I took for this event, I took more than 100 pictures. But when I post it, I don't put 100 pictures. I put only the best, okay? Because most of the time I get blurred images, okay? I myself get a blurred image because I might be wrong or sometimes I might miss the scene, okay? So in that time, it becomes a problem for me myself, okay? So it can happen to anyone if it happens to me. So you cannot be so perfect with photography, but you can keep clicking, and one day you'll become better. Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
So it depends on how fast and how many events you're attending and clicking the photos.
Yeah, and next class I will be trying to attend.
Yeah, that's fine. You can take your time. I mean, you can go through the pictures which I've taken. It is from last 2 years I'm doing this, like 2-3 years.
It's idea photography, yeah.
Yeah, so last 2 years, 2-3 years I'm doing this. And in a professional way, actually.
Yeah.
So, thanks for watching then.
Yeah.
All right, thanks.